Hey guys, Chris, Nichols Retirement Empire. Today, I believe I'm going to stop by Home Depot. I heard that they have their seeds out for the spring. So I'm going to pick up all my seeds today. So let's go check those out. I did get tagged in a challenge, and I cannot, it's something about the year in review or something to that effect, where you tell like what you talk about your garden for the year. I don't remember what all the questions are. I do know that one of the questions was, what was your most successful crop? My most successful crop for sure this year was okra. My okra was fantastic. I mean, it was way over my head. It was so high up I couldn't even reach the top of it. I had to bend it down to be able to reach the okra to cut it. It just did fantastic. My least successful crop, I know that was on there, I would have to say is my cantaloupes. I have not successfully grown cantaloupes. I know they're not hard to grow, I've just not treated them the right way, but I have not grown cantaloupes successfully in the last couple of years at all. So that was a disaster. My cantaloupes were a disaster. One of the things I did that I would not do again, I added a couple of kind of like raised bed areas on the outside of it. And when I added those raised bed areas, I put in a bunch of just debris, limbs and stuff like that, and then I put dirt on top of it. Well, I found out that that's not what you need to do, because all of that, while it is dying, is it's sucking nutrients out of that soil. So I messed up there. I had to go back. I had to add soil, more soil on top of it, and then fertilize it and all kind of stuff to try to get my fall crop. And all I got from my fall crop was I have some collards that have grown. I didn't prepare that right. I didn't prepare that soil right. But the collards are growing, and I have eaten the collards. Another thing that I was real happy that I did this year was when I started watching a lot of these garden videos on YouTube, I noticed that there were a lot of people, and you know, you have the different methods that people use. You know, some of them do the straw, and some of them do the any organic matter, and some people do the layering, and some people do the keyhole stuff and all that. I mean, I've looked at all that. I watch a lot of different ones. I did use mulch this year. I chose to use hay, which I guess would be the roost stout, but I haven't even gone and looked up to see what roost stout says. So, but I know people say that's what that is. So I threw some hay out there. I mulched. That really did. I'm really glad I did that, because it, you know, cut down on my weeds. I left a nice layer of hay out there over, you know, the winter. My goals for this next year is, this next year I'm going to put my tomatoes back in the ground. I used those grow bags for my tomatoes, and they grew great, but they didn't bear and they didn't produce good sized tomatoes. When I've had them in the ground, they've borne the best. My goals are, I want to be more successful with those. I want my strawberries to really bear this year. I made a really nice strawberry bed. I've got it mulched. The strawberries grew great. They're spreading and all that kind of stuff. So I'm hoping I'm gonna have a good strawberry crop next year on my little raised bed for my strawberries. And my other goals, I want to get those raised beds that are on the outside of my little garden area there where they are productive. If I need to add some more soil or whatever, I'll do that. My goals as far as YouTube, I have 800 subscribers. I pretty much have enough watch time to I would qualify for monetization. I have 800 and maybe 10 subscribers, like as of today. I think I could get to my 1,000 by the end of you know, by December next year, I'm hoping to be able to get that. So that's my goal. Gardner in Michigan. You might want to check her channel out. She does one of the Hugel culture, I think is what it's called, the keyhole gardening, which is really cool. She does really well. She is who tagged me on this challenge. And so, you know, you guys check her out if you have not already. She's got a nice little gardening channel there. Of course, you know, mine, I do more than gardening, but I do want to make sure that I keep my gardening stuff going, and I, you know, because I'm going to have a garden. And I want to, I have gotten a lot of good advice through YouTube, some of the stuff that I do. I'm not as serious about it as some of you guys. Some of you guys that I follow and watch, man, y'all are really fantastic gardeners, and you know exactly. I mean, y'all, you know, I'm like down here and y'all are way up there. You know, I'm just a guy retired and I got a garden. I'm definitely not a gardening expert, but everybody learns all the time. So that is who nominated me for this challenge. I'm supposed to nominate a couple of other people, and I really don't know who all has. Most of the gardeners that I have seen have done this already, or they have done another challenge that is like this. And this is like this. Somebody else had asked me right at the end of the year. I believe it was Ripe Tomato Farms. I think it was Ripe Tomato. No, it might have been Custom Garden Solutions. It was either Custom Garden Solutions or Ripe Tomato Farms. I believe it was Custom Garden Solutions that also asked me about this, and I told them I didn't really want to do it because I wasn't like a, you know, mainly a gardening channel. But after Gardening in Michigan asked me, I thought, well, I'll go ahead. So, and those are two good channels too. If you have not watched Custom Garden Solutions, that guy's a real pro. He does a great job explaining all kind of different. I mean, you know, him and also Ripe Tomato Farms. He hasn't been putting stuff on lately, but he is in the northwestern part of the United States, and then Custom Garden Solutions is in Arizona. So that's two different zones, two different gardening zones, and I mean, they are, like I said, they're real pros. They make a living at gardening. So you guys check them out as well. A beautiful, beautiful sight. They got everything. Okay. I know I want to do some inside. I don't know. I'm kind of debating about my inside and my outside with my herbs. But Tammy loves to have fresh herbs. I know she's going to want some basil. I'm not going to mess with cilantro. I know better than that. I learned my lesson with that. You can't grow cilantro for anything. Ooh, oregano. Dill. No. Thyme, for sure. Sage, for sure. Rosemary, for sure. I don't know, guys. With these sweet peppers, this is not... Usually I just get your standard bell. Let me see. Okay, this is my haul. I got my tomatoes, which I'm gonna try from seed this year. I've never done that. I'm gonna put them in this tray right here. Got all my herbs for my wife. She's excited about these. This is everything I'm gonna put outside. I'm gonna try cantaloupe again, even though it's been a disaster the last 2 years. This is the kind of okra I've used the last 2 years. It's done very well. I'm gonna get me some purple hull peas. Here's all my peppers, my sweet peppers, bell peppers, and then jalapenos, my collards for the fall, squash, always does well, beets I'm gonna put in a grow bag, broccoli in a grow bag, and carrots in a grow bag. So I'm gonna do a little pre-starting this year instead of just planting all of it in the ground.